Pastor Kyle here. We had a phenomenal Easter weekend at City Church. Many of you watching this probably attended, and now that it's over, you might be wondering, how do I keep Easter from just being an event that I attended that's now part of my personal history? Well, here are three of what I think are the most important things to do after Easter, or any other Christian holiday for that matter. Number one, have the kind of faith that's bigger than a Christian holiday. I'll tell you a secret that you probably already know if you've been a Christian for a while. The primary difference between Easter Sunday and every other quote-unquote normal Sunday in church is that more people show up. Healthy churches proclaim the resurrection life every week through the preaching of God's word. Now, I'm not saying that Easter isn't a special time. It is. All I'm saying is that the true fulfillment of Easter inside of every believer is the ongoing walking in newness of life. Romans 6:4 says we were buried with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. Number two, remember this. Rhythms create results. It's a bit like working out. Everyone knows they should eat healthy and exercise, but few people actually do it. Only through the implementation of disciplined rhythms will a person begin to see results, physically speaking. The most powerful opportunity to grow is when you don't feel like doing something and you do it anyways. Well, the same thing is true for our spiritual life. Here are a couple rhythms I would encourage you to start implementing, or maybe implementing again. Number one, start coming to City Church on Sundays as a discipline. The weekly gathering of the saints is an experience unlike any other in our faith, as God intended it to be. I can't tell you how many times I've had an encouraging conversation in the courtyard, I was touched by the worship, or I was challenged by a message in church. If this rhythm is already present in your life, keep it up. Make Bible reading a priority again. By the way, this isn't just a reminder for newer Christians. It's amazing how many times longtime Christians can drift from the reading of the Word of God. You might have really felt the Spirit of God move on Easter Sunday. That is awesome. But feelings don't really change anything in and of themselves. Here's what does change us: rhythms. Rhythms create results. Start up some new simple rhythms again and watch what God does in your life. Number three, allow God to continue to stir me up to even greater works. One of the primary tasks of the church is to remind and stir up the faithful. Following Jesus is an everyday process that takes commitment. One way you can allow God to stir you up to even greater works is to sign up to attend our Awaken seminar happening Saturday, April 28th. We believe it will be monumental in your faith. If you sign up right now, you'll receive the super early bird discount of $10 off a person. The only trick is that you have to sign up before Sunday or the price goes up. We have geared this entire year to be a year of discovery. This is the first of four events that you won't want to miss. Hebrews 10, 23 and 24 says, let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. So don't let Easter Sunday be a dead end in your faith. Let it be a catalyst for the new things God wants to do inside of you and in this church. I'll be starting a new series on the book of Jonah this Sunday, and I would love to see you there for it.